Hello, today we are in this neoclassical building from the 1860 designed by Giuseppe Valadier. It's also called Café del Pincio. It's right one of the most central places in Rome, in Pincian Hill, which is near to Borghese Gallery, where you have the most important art of Rome. But this building, it had his importance during the unification of Italy until the 1900, turned to be a place also later on during the World War II, it was occupied by the German troops. And it was closed down until the year 2000, so 2004, they reopened it into this super elegant place for restaurant and wine tasting, and also to celebrate some amazing dinners here, like New Year's or great festivities you come to see in Rome. So come and check out this place, because you absolutely gonna love it. We still have original frescoes from the late 1800s, and it's a jewel. So you are 5 minutes away from Piazza del Popolo. All you have to do, climb these stairs, and you have this beautiful park. This place has a fascinating story, because it was occupied during the 1943. Senti il dolore nella musica, senza dal pianoforte. Ma quando vide la luna uscire da una nuvola, gli sembrò più dolce anche la morte. Guardò negli occhi la ragazza, quegli occhi verdi come il mare. Poi all'improvviso uscì una lacrima. E lui credette d'affogare. Te voglio bene assai, ma tanto, tanto bene sai. E no catena ormai, che sciogli. Potenza della lirica, dove ogni dramma è un falso, che con un po' di trucco e con la mimica puoi diventare un altro. Ma due occhi che ti guardano, così vicini e veri, ti fa scordare le parole, confondono pensieri. Così diventò tutto piccolo, anche le notti là in America. Ti volti e vedi la tua vita, come la bianca scia domenica. Ma sì, è la vita che finisce, ma lui non ci pensò poi tanto. This is one of the most beautiful buildings of the Renaissance style. The Medici owned this villa from 1683. Later on was passed into Lorena. They were ruled here. Galileo Galilei was kept in this villa down here. This is commissioned by Ferdinando de' Medici to the architect Bartolomeo Mannati. This villa was used as a property of the Medici family for the past 200 years, and later on was passed into the noble family of Lorena. In this villa, obviously, Napoleon confiscated this area in 1803. Now, the importance of this villa in the Renaissance, all the Medici had all their beautiful sculptures, like the statues you see when you're in the Piazza della Signoria in Florence. You see all the beautiful exhibition on the right side under the portico, which is called Loggia dei Lanzi. This is where you see all the antiquity Roman sculptures that were brought by the Medici from this villa in Florence, and they were exhibited there for the past 200 years now.
probably one of the best locations of Rome, because on the left you have the Spanish Stairs, and on the right you have the Pincian Hill and the beautiful Borghese Garden. Right next to us we have this beautiful church from the Renaissance time called Trinità di Monti. And obviously not to forget this beautiful terrace down here that is owned by the Hotel Hessler. So this villa has an incredible, beautiful garden, but always you have to reserve in advance to see this building because it's still owned by the Academy of France. So to book the reservations, you have to go on their website and you understand all the details, what to do before coming here. The three most important things that were found in this villa is the Venus of Medici, which you find in the Uffizi in Florence. Then you find that beautiful bathtub, which is at the Boboli Garden in Florence, and the obelisk in the garden of Palazzo Pitti in Florence. So literally a whole antiquity of sculptures were kept here by the Medici family. When the Medici moved to Florence, they brought everything with them there. In the back here, and most of the people come here in the nighttime to have happy hour and great wine and cocktails. So this is probably the best place to be if you're hanging out by the Spanish Steps. Come and check out this place. Ed arriva dritto al cuore, senza nemmeno avvisare. In una lettera d'amore, è nel canto del mare, è il ricordo di un amore, ci parla e non ci passa. Se avessi avuto almeno un'occasione, adesso che so capire le parole, ma il ricordo di un amore continua a viaggiare nel